All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the first round of speeches. And it brings me great pleasure to introduce our best man, Cameron, to come to the floor with our bride and groom. Make your way down.
Yeah. Thanks,
Sam. Well, you gotta have some fun.
We will. We will.
Welcome, welcome, everyone. To those of you who haven't had the pleasure of meeting me, my name is Cam. I'm honoured to stand here before you today as Ben's best man for this very special occasion. I want to start by congratulating the newlyweds, Chloe and Ben. Round of applause. And I also want to thank both of their parents, Vicky and Tim, and David and Carolyn, for having us all here tonight and putting on such an amazing event. And finally, thank you to each and every one of you for coming tonight and for your generous gifts to the bride and the groom. I'm going to keep this short and sharp, as Ben has assured me he'll be heading downstairs to the casino shortly to exchange all of your wedding gifts for casino chips. When Ben first asked me to be his best man, I was both thrilled and extremely nervous. Thrilled because it serves as a fantastic opportunity to make jokes at Ben's expense, but also nervous upon realising this is a traditional Greek wedding with over 200 guests in attendance. When I was preparing this speech, I did what any good best man would do, and I went directly to ChatGPT. I've typed in, write me a best man speech for Ben Sawyers. As expected, ChatGPT was unable to complete my request due to it being an intelligent computing algorithm unable to comprehend the illogical and irrational man that is Ben Sawyers. This meant I had to go about it the old-fashioned way, wading through countless stories and moments Ben had blessed us with over the past 27 years. So here goes. Those of you who know Ben well know he's a supremely and motivated and upbeat person. That was the joke, by the way. A little after Ben and Chloe first met, Ben said to me, "Dude, I really think Chloe's the one." As with any male, it's rare you can trust them, even rarer that they're right. So I said, "Wow, Ben, that's great to hear, mate." To which he responded, "I love her so much, I'm even going to learn Greek." That's about when I knew he was deadly serious. Roughly 6 years have passed since Ben made such a bold claim. Upon checking into his progress at mastering such a unique and nuanced language, Ben can speak all of, how many words, Ben? I think it was 2 words. For those interested, he can say panamorphe and ipostiko, translating to beautiful and shed. One to keep Chloe happy and the other for Tim. There are so many reasons why Chloe and Ben are perfect together. The first that comes to mind is Ben's love of spending time with his close friends. However, Ben wasn't always like this. In fact, when Ben and I first became friends growing up, we only hung out because our parents would force us to, just to get us out of the house. Thankfully, Ben now has someone to hang out with every day, and he does it by choice this time. And for the record, I now hang out with Ben by choice too. Now on to the good stuff. I'm sure it will come as no surprise to anyone, but Ben was known to get into trouble during his schooling years. Never anything too serious, but trouble nonetheless. During year 12, Ben and an assortment of his schoolmates would often skip assembly and hide behind the drama hall. You guys know who you are? One fateful afternoon, we'd all assembled in the hiding spot and were ready for another missed assembly. To provide some context, you had to run to the hiding spot quickly, otherwise you'd be spotted by a teacher. However, much to our dismay, there was one boy lagging behind, seemingly in no rush to join the rest of us. Shall we take bets on who it was? Inevitably, a teacher spots Ben and beelines straight to him. When confronted, Ben folds like a lawn chair and confesses to his crimes immediately. Keep in mind, we're watching this unfold from the area we were hiding in. Ben was asked if he acted alone, to which we watched him point directly at us without a moment's hesitation. The teachers then wandered over to the hiding spot and the teachers peered through in disbelief, even stating, "There's no way a student could be hiding back there." But alas, one of us snickered and we were sprung. In the end, we were each rewarded with a lunchtime detention to be experienced with none other than our good friend Ben. I think we need to take this moment to let Chloe appreciate just how lucky she is, knowing that she will never miss out on an experience, good or bad. Speaking of luck, I think Ben is very lucky to have Chloe, and he knows this. He once said to Joseph and I, "You guys know, lightning doesn't strike the same spot twice," referring to how lucky he was to be with Chloe. Now, although he certainly is right that he is very lucky to have Chloe, although I do think he got it slightly wrong. Because Ben, you are just that lucky that lightning can strike the same spot twice. Because you also got me. I just want to say how honored I am to be standing up here today. Ben, you're a true friend, and I couldn't be happier for you and Chloe. You two are a perfect match, and I have no doubt that you'll be happy together for a lifetime. So let's all raise a glass to the happy couple. May your lives be filled with love and laughter, and of course, luck on the roulette table tonight. Cheers.
Another round of applause for our best man, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to keep our bride and groom on the dance floor because Ben is now going to say a few words. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Awesome. All right. Hi, everyone. Thank you for coming. Really appreciate seeing you all here today. It means a lot to Chloe and I. I'm just going to keep this short and sharp. I'm not much of a public speaker, nor do I like long speeches. So, yeah, we'll keep this very short. Firstly, I want to thank Mum, Dad, Vicky and Tim for organising and planning everything tonight. It's a massive surprise that I did not contribute, but Vicky and Chloe worked together tirelessly to get this whole thing done. I'd honestly say there was 100 appointments about every single detail here, like everything. Absolutely unbelievable, like the cutlery and stuff. So there's a thing about everything. Next thing I want to do is thank the groomsmen and the bridesmaids. These guys have really contributed to our lives and they're a big part of our character, developed our character, being good friends with us for all this time. I've known them all for many years and so has Chloe, and honestly, we speak to them most of them every single week at least, so it means a lot to see these guys. Lastly, I want to say I'm so lucky to have you, Chloe. So happy to be marrying the love of my life. Chloe, you're absolutely amazing. I can't believe how lucky I am to have you with me today. Your beauty, intelligence, and kind heart are just a few of the many things I love about you. I'm so excited to start this new chapter in our lives together and to see what holds in the future. I promise to always be there for you, to support you, and to love you unconditionally. Thank you for being my partner, my best friend, and my soulmate. In that being said, could everyone please raise a glass for Chloe and I? Give us a big woohoo when it's, yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Ben and Chloe. Well, that concludes the first part of tonight's speeches, ladies and gentlemen. Your mains will be served shortly. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to start the second round of speeches. Could you please take your seats in preparation for the father of the bride to say a few words? Thank you. Make him feel welcome, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening. On behalf of my wife Vicky and my family, I would like to warmly welcome relatives and friends of both families and thank you all for being here, especially those of you who have travelled a long distance to join us and contribute to make this occasion unforgettable. Today is a day of great joy, love and celebration as we gather to witness the union of our beloved daughter Chloe and her charming partner Ben. I would like to thank you both for celebrating the wedding with us, your heartfelt wishes, generous gifts and support. I'm so happy to have our parents here with us, Alex Karatinos and Kaliroi Georgiakopoulos. It makes the day even more special. I also acknowledge and respect those who have left us, my mother-in-law Eleni and my father Yanni. I've been waiting for this moment for 27 years and I must say that it was one of the most difficult and most pleasant things I've ever had to do. Although it is overwhelming to give your daughter away, it is so satisfying to know that she's marrying Ben, an exceptional young man, which is truly gratifying. Marriages like births mark a new chapter in your life. To be the father of another daughter is a lovely feeling. The day Chloe arrived in this world, the responsibility grew overnight. The family grew from 4 to 5. Thoughts came racing through my head. Is the house big enough? Is the car big enough? Schooling, etc., etc. But anticipation for her life, her journey, and our relationship helped me overcome my fears and work hard to be a father worthy of such a daughter. God blessed us with this special girl with an insatiable smile and a beautiful, huge heart. Chloe, when I first held you in my arms, I remember staring at your little features and feeling thrilled at each new sound and expression. A fierce need to protect you came over me then and has never gone away. Wow, what can I say about Chloe? What a special person our daughter is. It's difficult to describe her, but I'll give it a go. Loving, caring, respectful, brutally honest, social, appreciates wining and dining, her unwavering love for her family and a love for her furry companion Zulu, which fills a piece of her heart now. And then there is Ben, who she absolutely adores. Chloe, throughout the years, I have watched you blossom into a remarkable woman, full of grace, intelligence and kindness. You've always been a source of joy and inspiration to our family, and I'm awed in the person you have become. Chloe's always possessed a remarkable ability to see the best in people, but at the same time, she has little patience for foolishness. I was amazed by her incredible level of compassion even as a young girl. When she started attending school, she made it her mission to befriend everyone in her class, regardless of her social status or personality. She had a unique talent for recognizing the strengths and goodness in each individual. I recall her intervening in arguments between friends who wanted to play or sit beside her, demonstrating her sensitivity and maturity at a very young age. Chloe loved ballet and did it for over 10 years, dancing, jazz concerts. It was a huge part of her life as well as ours. She also loved athletics and was a good sprinter in her time at school. It runs in the family. Oh, some people got it. I love our walks together. Even now, Chloe would text me, up for a walk tonight? I never say no. Funny enough, we have similar likes and dislikes. Taste for dogs, close, but not lately. Chloe's a real deep thinker. She knows what she wants. I was not surprised when she went to psychology. She started off in psychology, changed nutrition, which she was never truly happy, and then headed back to psychology where she completed her honours. We all take immense pride in our outstanding accomplishments thus far. As I said at Chloe's and Ben's engagement, they're very suited. They laugh a lot, enjoy each other's company, and are very happy to spend time with each other while not ignoring their circle of friends and family. They really complement each other. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Ben's parents, David and Carolyn, for raising such a wonderful young man who loves our daughter, Chloe, dearly. Ben, you're an amazing person. We're glad that you're part of our family, and I'm proud to call and have you as a son-in-law. I'm confident that you'll take care of our Chloe, and since day one, my impression of you has not changed. Thank you for treating my daughter like gold. I know in my heart that you'll be the perfect match. Chloe and Ben have poured their hearts and souls into planning this beautiful wedding, and it's safe to say that everyone here agrees that the ceremony was absolutely stunning. I want to express my sincere gratitude to all the staff at EOS who have gone above and beyond to make this evening unforgettable. I also want to give a special shout out to Peter, Savas, the DJ, as well as Johnny, Christina, Connie, Chris and Mary, and Lance, Emmy, and everyone else involved in making this wedding day so special. Big thank you to her godparents, Nick and Natalie Spiro as well, who've been an integral part of their life as well, Badaxi. Your hard work and dedication has not gone unnoticed, and we are forever grateful. Last but not least, I want to give a huge thank to my amazing wife, Vicky, for unwavering commitment and tireless efforts. Your love and support are what makes our lives so rich and fulfilling, and I feel incredibly blessed to have you as my partner in everything. Thank you for being truly awesome and for always bringing so much joy and light into our lives. My advice to both of you is always to be true to each other, share your good times and your bad times, love in abundance and laugh frequently, smile and always be a best friend to each other. Speak well of one another in private and especially in public. And when things don't go right, forgive always. Married life is a journey, it's tough, and today you embark on living this adventure we call life together. Your wedding vows and covenant taken today in church make you as a couple more important than either of you could be separate. Another piece of advice to my new son-in-law, Ben, forget your wedding anniversary once and you remember it for the rest of your life. Chloe is your dad. Never forget that I love you. I hope you believe in yourself as much as I believe in you. When life tries to knock you down, I always have your back. I can't promise to be here for the rest of your life, but what I can promise is that I'll love you for the rest of mine. All that remains for me to ask you to join me for a toast to the happy couple. May you both live as long as you like and have all that you need for as long as you live. To the newlyweds, I wish you a wonderful, joyous marriage filled with love and with an undying partnership. Cheers to a lifetime of love, prosperity and happiness. With all my heart, congratulations, Chloe and Ben.
Another round of applause for the team, ladies and gentlemen. Now, from one father to another, I'd like to invite David to say a few words.
Hi everyone, we hope you are having a great night. We are Ben's parents. We are very proud of Ben's achievements in life and in particular with his studies in his field of employment. We are also proud of his wife Chloe, who he has been dating for 7 years. In those 7 years, we have never witnessed any bickering or arguing, and we believe is testament to Chloe's fine upbringing under the sound guidance of Tim and Vicky. We are certain that this strength is the foundation stone to a stable, strong, and successful marriage. In particular, I personally would like to thank my wife's parents, Lois and Max Ramsey, for all of the love and support given to Ben over the past 27 years. We would also like to thank my sister and her husband, Don Rankin, for the time, effort and interest shown in Ben during his journey. Regretfully, we lost Max Ramsey last Christmas, and that's a very sad time for us all. It's a shame that my mother, Nancy, did not live long enough to meet this good bloke named Ben Sawyers, who we love. In closing, many, many thanks to the wonderful Vicky and Tim for the time, effort and resources poured into this celebration tonight. Thank you all, and we hope you have a splendid night. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, another big round of applause for our parents tonight.
You can head back now.
Now that concludes tonight's speeches. We'll be back shortly for the father-daughter dance. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to kick off. Tim, Chloe, could I please have you onto the dance floor for the father-daughter dance? Make them feel welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Straight to the middle.
Your mom and I are a mess, seeing you in that dress. Our little girl is now grown, and I remember how sweet when you danced on my feet. Now you stand on your own. You'll always be my little girl, my whole life, my whole world, my little girl. This dance is more than just a dance. It gives me one more chance to show the world how proud I am of you. And as we dance, dance around this room like we did when you were two, my little girl, this dance is just for you. Fill my eyes as I realize I have to give you away. You'll always be my little girl.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Tim and Chloe. Now, from one special man to another in your life, your husband, Ben. Ben, she's over here. Megan, feel welcome, ladies and gentlemen. A round of applause for our bride and groom. It's now their first dance.
The feeling I'm going through, I just can't say I don't love you, 'cause I love you. Yeah. It's hard for me to communicate the thoughts that I hold, but tonight I'm gonna let you know. Let me tell the truth, baby, let me tell the truth. Yeah. You know what I'm thinking, see it in your eyes. You hate that you want me, hate it when you cry. You're scared to be lonely, especially in the night. I'm scared that I'll miss you, happens every time. I don't want this feeling, I can't afford love. I try to find this love to pull us apart. It ain't working, 'cause you're perfect, and I know that you're worth it. I can't walk away.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Chloe and Ben. Family and friends, the dance floor is now open. Please come and join us.
I'm blaming you.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the dance floor is open.